GTA. Cars. Casper. MMI. Long ago, I battled two beasts of medical school applications, GPA and cars. Then everything changed when Casper attacked.
Casper's gonna be so easy, like, I'm not even gonna study for it. I mean, plus, my GPA and cars were so good anyways, so yeah, I'm not really worried.
Dude, I don't know about that. Look what happened to him. He had a 136 cars and a 4.7 GPA.
Eh, probably had like a word per minute of, you know, 10. Slow typing speed and all.
Alright, if you say so. Good luck.
Good luck to you too, man.
It's finally the big day. Time to get this bread.
Stay back! I have a word per minute of 250 and you don't know what I can do to you!
Good morning, everyone, and welcome. I'm Dr. Rob White, the Associate Dean of Undergraduate Medical Education at the Michael G. DeGroot School of Medicine, and I am so excited to be talking to you all today. During these unprecedented times, we'd like to take the time to congratulate you on your achievements. You are all extremely competitive applicants.
Communicator, collaborator, leader, advocate, scholar.
Oh no. Everything is such a mess. Where are my good interview clothes? Honey, have you seen my lucky blazer?
Shoot. How did that surgery take so long? It was only supposed to be a simple pancreatoduodenectomy. Oh, I'm gonna be so late. And then I have a horizontal elective tomorrow morning and 5 interest group meetings in the afternoon. Oh, and then I can't forget about that speaker panel I'm supposed to attend. Oh, can I just take a leave of absence for the rest of this week?
Today's the day, y'all. You have been waiting 6 months for this day. And it is finally here, and you are gonna kill it! You miss 100% of the shots you don't take. Wayne Gretzky, Michael Scott, so go out there and show them what you're made of.
Protein check, fats check, carbs check.
Nothing like hitting all the macros to start off interview day. Keeping the body fueled and the mind sharp. Let's do this.
Oh my God, guys, I've been practicing this for so long. I've got this. 100%.
No, that's not the right...
I'll meet you guys there, okay? At their location. Okay, wait. Hold up, guys. Oh, no. Wait, McMaster interview in... Wait, 10 minutes. I'm sorry. I have to go. Bye-bye.
Stripes. No, blue. No, definitely stripes. Okay, stripes. Yes, I'm committed.
Polka dots would look nice.
No, polka dots wouldn't work. Or would they?
I'm so excited to be talking to you all today. During these unprecedented times, I'd like to take...
And that concludes the welcome address. I can only imagine the restlessness you are all feeling, sitting at your desks and listening intently to me speaking. Please use this time to take a break. Feel free to stand up and step away from your computers, grab some water or maybe a snack, and take a quick break before your interviews commence. Best of luck.
Honey! Is my tea ready?
Oh, after that long session, TikTok is exactly what I need.
Yeah. I don't know.
A smile from the pack. Elephants and acrobats. Lions, snakes, monkeys. Village speaks righteous, Sister Cena says funky. How bizarre.
All the leaves are brown.
Everyone, here is a glimpse into the daily life of a McMaster med student. At 8:45, I usually wake up and make breakfast for my 9 a.m. Zoom class. I eat breakfast while listening to the lecture portion. Then I use the short break to make myself presentable for our small group discussion, because for this part of the class, we have our cameras on. After class, I usually make myself a nutritious lunch, which is around noon. I spend the afternoon doing schoolwork, reading for fun, and taking a really good nap. I also love going for a short walk in the afternoon to get some sunlight, some fresh air, and exercise, and also to check on the neighbor's cat, of course. Then I have to get myself ready to go to campus for my in-person clinical skills class. I'm usually tired when I get home, so I grab something to eat for dinner, do a bit of work, watch some Netflix, before going to sleep. And that's my day. If you like the way I talk, then why am I on your mind? If you like the way I rock, then finish your glass of wine.
My recital, I think it's very vital to rock around. That's right, on top. It's tricky, it's so tight. Here we go. It's tricky to rock around, to rock around. That's right, on time. It's tricky, it's tricky, 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 tricky. Tricky. It's tricky to rock around, that's right, on time. It's tricky, 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 tricky. I met this little girlie, her hair was kind of curly.
For you, I kinda want to. Cause 3 years for an MD and a down to.
Switching this in rotations for you. Percussion and the clinic, and I'm in the ER too. I'm on horizontals where I'm jumping through rooms. FSR, lip, nothing, now, well, then. clerkship cuts a DR2. Ready for a clerkship when you're using all these tools. MacMath is great, and we hope you think so too. Nothing we won't do, switching for you. Yeah.
Why do you want to go to McMaster?
Oh no.
So, I want to go to McMaster because,
Hello?
Hi!
I mean, I'm considering that, you know? Like, it would be cool to get in, but
more importantly, what are the parties like?
So, what would you tell your friend in this situation?
Well, I just don't think I have enough information to answer this question.
You see, before making a decision, I would need to consider all aspects of the situation.
For example, in order to perform an accurate probabilistic risk assessment, I would like to know what daycare my friend attended, and then, you know,
perhaps read a few papers on how hair color can impact sleep. That would be fascinating.
But then I'd really have to assess the quality of my friendship to determine if this person's even worth my time. How long have I known this person? Is this person even my friend?
And then finally, and most importantly, is what even is a friend?
Oh, yeah, I would consider the four principles of medical ethics, which are beneficence, autonomy, justice, and autonomy.
It's not lupus. It's never lupus.
So yeah, let me know if you want to talk about anything.
What was your GPA?
What was your credit score?
What did you get on your MCAT? How do I become a neonatal palliative care cardiothoracic surgeon?
Well, what are my chances of getting admitted?
So, what good restaurants are there around campus?
Okay, the next step is to fold in the corner.
What does that mean? What does fold in the corner mean?
You fold it in.
I understand that, but how do you fold it in? Do you fold it in half like a piece of paper? What do?
Sir, I cannot show you everything.
Okay, well, can you show me one thing?
Here's what you do. You just fold it in.
Okay. I don't know how to fold the paper like that.
And I don't know how to be any clearer. You take the thing that's in your hands and you...
If you say fold it in one more time...
I said fold it.
These are your instructions. You fold in the corner then.
Don't you dare, sir, sir.
Well, that's all the questions I have for you. Do you have any questions for us?
Well, why should I choose Mac?
Imagine you're standing beside tram tracks, and in the distance, you spot a runaway trolley hurling towards a principle of medical ethics.
But you can only save one. Which is the most important?
But they're all important.
my name is Autopedic, and I'm going to be using a hammer to check your reflexes today. Is that okay with you?
Yeah, that's fine.
What the heck is this? Oh, wait. The task said to use a hammer. It's hammer time.
You can't touch this. You can't touch this.
Okay, our next task is to go to MDCL and take a profile pic in the waterfall room. You know where MDCL is? Let me check my map. Yeah, it's right beside HSC. Come on, I'll lead the way. The map says it should be right here. I don't think we're in Hamilton anymore. Can you determine what murmur this patient has, please?
But ma'am, this is a statue.
There is no way to refer to your patients. Please proceed. Okay, so what murmur does he have?
I think it's an aortic stenosis murmur?
Wrong. He's clearly a statue. You shouldn't be able to hear anything.
That's what I said!
No excuses. Okay, a heart. I got this. Yeah. I think that's right.
Hey. Corporate needs you to find the differences between this X-ray and this X-ray. Intel has told us that there are at least 7. They're the same, that's right.
What the?
What happened?
I found this abandoned. Alright, so I just finished a history, and I was on my way to prepare for the DRE, when I just randomly found this on the ground!
How could someone leave their stethoscope on the ground like that? It's even a special edition cardiology stethoscope. Maybe I should trade with them.
I was just in the corner doing my tasks when this was called. I was doing so well. Whoa there. Someone sabotaged right as I was checking McBurney's point, and I went straight to the code.
Me? I was in BSB. I never know what I'm supposed to know, and I kind of just wander around all the time and hope that I'm doing the right thing. I don't even know what happened. I don't even know how to use my stethoscope. And what is a sphygma manometer and Trendelenburg anyway? Wait, do I even have my stethoscope? Was that my stethoscope? Am I the imposter?
Am I the imposter?
Am I the imposter?
Am I the imposter?
Are we all imposters?
Sup? What the heck are you talking about? Get those wild thoughts out of your head. You worked your butt off to get into med.
Just think, learning to auscultate, history take. Poppy and percuss, is that a mess that I feel? I don't know what I feel. PPE donned, gown, tie, gloves on, and don't forget your mask, now go.
Where are all your friends, tutors and preceptors? You think you don't belong, we think you've got it wrong. Grab your white coat, keep auscultating, yeah. OPQRST, don't forget meds and allergies.
Come on and hang your backpack up next to mine, then just get in line, then I whip out my stethoscope and listen in hopes that I catch that stroke.
Hamilton, Waterloo, Niagara, so much of Mac to explore.
Gotta get it.
Procom, clinskills, PBL, and ICCGs, I just act confused.
Are you catching on?
We just want you to know that Mac's really the best, no doubt though.
We still don't know what we don't even know, but we're getting that just fine and learning as we go. Doohees and thrills, CBA tenderness, bruise and reflexes, so many tests to know.
MacMed, we've got so much time to spare.
HSC, strut around like you own the place.
Pass the Casper days, MCAT and GPA, cause we've been saving a MacMed invite for you. Cause once you're here, Mac's only 3 years long, you're in and out like that, enjoy it while it lasts.